Good afternoon. Today I am here to give presentation on my consultancy project I completed on Unze Shoes. I evaluated their operations management techniques and came up with a new sustainable supply chain management strategy. When I first met the CEO, he knew the problem is in operations, but he was unsure what exactly is the problem and which part of the operations. So what was decided is that we will evaluate the overall operations management strategy. We will do the external and internal analysis, then benchmark the strategy with the best practices in the industry and come up with a new strategy for the company. Talking about the industry, if you look at the footwear industry, the company before 2008 was doing really good, but after the recession, the manufacturers decreased from 220 to 180, the major reason because of the cheaper imports from Far East Asia. At the same time, another big change was the introduction of grocery and discount retail shoe shops, which does not actually exist back in 1995, but right now they have major market share in overall industry. Talking about the Unze shoes, the company actually started back in 1987 with the name of Shalimar Shoes. In 2001, they relaunched their brand with the name of Unze Shoes. They have online shops as well, and at the same time, they have a factory outlet in East Ham. If you look at the current structure of the company, there is one CEO and two directors, followed by four managers and around 40 to 50 permanent and temporary staff. Looking at the current financial statement of the company, the current assets and current cash at bank both are decreased because they paid their current liabilities. But the alarming factor for the company right now is their net worth, which decreases by 22%, which shows that the company is having huge losses and in future they can face the problem of illiquidity. Talking about the current supply chain strategies they are following, the first one, forecasting. They are following jury of executive opinion where there is a proportion of 50% from the retail managers and 50% from the shop managers, and then they decide the forecast for the next day. Why they are using it? According to the retail manager, he says it's really flexible and easy for them to actually order for the future. In case of inventory control, they are using periodic inventory control in which there is variable orders after every 6 days depending upon the demand. Talking about the distribution network they are currently using, you can see it's really simple and it's really straightforward. All the European suppliers, they supply at the doorstep of the warehouse, and from there it is actually delivered to all the 6 shops. Why they are using it? Order visibility is really clear, it's easy, and at the same time it's easy to manage the inventory and easy handling for the overall staff. Talking about the transportation, currently they are using 2 routes, one for the shops which are a bit far from the warehouse, Croydon and Southall, and the other one is for the shops which are near Stratford, Ilford, Greenford, Whitechapel. So twice in a week they have one van which actually goes and deliver all the stock on route 1 and route 2. Last but not the least, quality control. They use a relatively simple method in quality control. What they do is when they receive defective shoes, they take pictures of them and send it to the supplier, and supplier actually exchange those shoes without any cost. And why they are using, it's easy for them and it's really straightforward for them to get to replace those shoes. Okay, the methodology I applied in this research was surveys. I did questionnaire analysis in which I took a sample of 60 people and checked the customer gap actually. I took the interviews from the shop manager, retail manager and all the people who were directly or indirectly concerned with the supply chain management of the company to get more and more primary data. Because I'm still at the start of the implementation, to support my argument, I used empirical evidence of case study approach, in which I used different case studies to make sure that what I'm arguing right now will work in the future. Data was analyzed by external analysis and internal analysis using both the score model and consumer descriptive analysis. In case of limitations, the biggest 2 limitations I faced as a consultant, the first one was the culture of the organization. Currently, they are using hierarchical culture in which it's really centralized because it's a family business, you have to understand this, and there is a lot of control. The problem for a consultant, research has proved that the culture should be a mix of group culture and development culture so that the people are flexible, they are ready to change, they accept innovation, and there is teamwork and participation from the people. So If the company moves towards this culture, it will be easier for me to actually implement my strategies. Talking about the second problem, second limitation I faced was the reliability of information. There was a lot of information for being a but being a consultant, it was difficult for me to judge which information should be validated and included in the project. Coming to the external analysis, it is really important for a company to analyze that what are the macro environments and how it can affect in future. Talking about the SWOT analysis of the industry, there is the strength of the industry is the strong demand and knowledgeable consumers. The weakness, losing profit margins because of the advent of discount and value retailers. But if you have a good hybrid strategy, if a company is following a good hybrid strategy, they can change this into a new opportunity. Talking about the market trend analysis, fashion is basically fast, and there is continuous change in the trends, which gives companies an opportunity to come up with new products. There's an increase in population, increase in employment by 5%, household income increases by 4.6%, which all gives company a chance to increase their market share. Last but not the least, the market size is also increasing as well. Until 2016, it is expected that the market will increase by 5.8%. Talking about the pest analysis, definitely the stagnant European legislation on labor laws is affecting the companies, but if you have a good corporate governance strategy, you can make it into a competitive advantage. Cheap imports and 50% spending is basically a good positive point for the companies. Endorsement is actually a good social impact. And last but not the least, the technology is taking more and more impact on the overall industry, and new forms and shapes have been introduced and anticipated by the consumers as well. Porter 5 forces, barriers to entry are basically high to moderate, bargaining power of buyers because there are so many suppliers is actually high, bargaining power of suppliers is low, threat of substitute does not exist because it's treated as a specialized industry now, and competitive rivalry is high. So if you look at the four different analysis, we can actually conclude that there is potential in the market, and if the company uses internal resources properly, they can actually grow in future. Talking about the internal analysis, the first model I used was score analysis. I actually did the benchmarking, level 1 diagnosis and level 2 diagnosis of score analysis, and compared it with the shoe zone. The point of comparing it was with shoe zone was that both of the companies actually provide the same products to the consumers. In case of supply chain reliability, Unze Shoes is lagging behind by 21% in perfect order fulfillment. When analyzed, the problem was missing inventory. Supply chain responsiveness and flexibility, the lead time is more, which is another problem for the company. And in case of asset management, if you look at the cash conversion cycle and compare it, the problem was that Unze takes 34 more days than Shoe Zone to convert inventory into cash, which can lead to illiquidity and bankruptcy in future. Talking about the consumer analysis, I took a sample of 60 people. Actually, the sample was 100, but only I got the filled questionnaire of 60 people. When I calculated the mean aggregate, the expectation was 5. The mean aggregate of all the attributes, which actually tell about the customer gap in expectation, all the attributes were from 2 to 4, which shows the company is not doing really good. Major highlights were missing inventory, product availability is not there, poor quality, staff attitude, and last but not the least, all of them actually leads to poor customer satisfaction and poor customer retention. So after internal analysis, you can actually see that the problem is basically internally but not externally. If you see, the biggest gap is ineffective inventory forecasting method. Empirical evidence, Mirza International Company have the same problem. What they did, came up with a new qualitative program. The company is not ready to invest, and I have 1 month to implement with a new strategy. Second gap was poor inventory management. Shoe Zone has the same problem. They are not ready to invest. Maximum 2 months to actually, and what I will make, I will come up with a new warehouse replenishment technique. Third one, no consumer research in the company as yet. Zara is doing it. Investment plan, yes, they will invest in secondary research. Excuse me. Maximum 3 months, feedback and consumer research will be the option. Slow inventory replenishment, SRG has the same problem. Client assessment, is basically they are not ready to invest 4 to 6 months to actually implement this strategy. What I will do, I will come up with new SKU management technique. Fifth is unsatisfactory shop experience. Zara faced the same problem. They came up with a new transformation of employees. They trained there. I will do the same in the company. There is no investment plan other than maybe getting a new trainer for the employees. Maximum time given to me is 2 months. Now coming to the recommendations. The first recommendation, previously the company was using qualitative technique of jury of executive opinion. I came up with a quantitative forecasting technique, in which I uses 2-day weighted moving average of 10-90 proportion with exponential smoothing. Previously, the forecasting error was 5.2%. I reduced it to 2.3%. And the graph shows that almost the sales are followed by the exponential smoothing, so the error will reduce with time. Furthermore, other than this, I made a new program for the company in which if the company puts last day sales and today's sales, the manager will get to know the next day order and he can always change the alpha, his input in percentage as well. If I put it as order number 1 and run this macro, which I'm still working on this, if I run this macro, you can see that everything will be saved in this sheet, and later the retail manager, he can calculate the mean absolute percentage error and change the alpha bit time. And everything will be done with this button, but I'm still finalizing this program as yet. Coming back to the presentation, the second recommendation was new warehouse management technique. Previously, when they receive from the supplier, they open the boxes, randomly check those boxes, rearrange them with new product codes. If they share this information with the supplier will give the same product code, supplier will print the barcodes for them, and as soon as they reach the inventory reaches the warehouse, they can print those, they can actually use the barcode reader and put them in the racks. It will save the lead time by 1%, and there will be cost saving as well, which I have mentioned in the notes. The third recommendation is SKU management. Taking the example of 2 SKUs, one was performing, one was non-performing in the same shop. Because the space is taken equally and there is limited space, the performing SKUs were sold in like 1 day, but the non-performing was unable to sell, which took the space from the other one, and the customers were lost because they wanted the performing SKU. What the company, other than this, they have write-off cost, losses, missing inventory losses, inventory holding cost losses. What the company can do is, the first one I already discussed, forecasting technique, we are already improving that. Consumer research I will discuss in the last slide. Stock wholesaler. Being a consultant, I found 3 or 4 stock wholesalers for them that before the inventory gets obsolete, you can actually sell them at cheaper price to them, and it will reduce the cost to the company. The next recommendation was new quality control technique. Previously, they just used the snaps and sent it to the supplier, and supplier actually changed the basically the defective shoes. What they can do is they can make just a graph on Excel and set a target. When they set a target, they can share this information with the supplier and just tell them that 1% of the total delivery can be defective, not more than that. Supplier 1, 2, 3. So they have to make sure that it should be less than 1%. If the defective parts are more than that, you can actually come up with new penalties for them, or you can change the suppliers as well. So they are always threatened that there are different opportunities. It will save the cost from 6 to 10%. Shop experience, there is a gap in expectation, and nowadays consumers are knowledgeable. They are always looking for, you know, expectations should be exceeded to make them satisfied and make them happy. These are the following steps taken. New feedback system is introduced in which every information will go to the retail manager at the end of the day. Mystery shopping, we are still in the process. We will hire persons, they will fill the questionnaires, they will go as a customer in the shops and then give feedback. Empowerment of employees, teams has been made between senior and junior members, and they will discuss everything with each other, and junior members will be directly dealing with the customers more openly. And shop atmosphere, we are working on that as well. More clean shops, more maybe the overall ambience will be changed as well. marketing consumer research. Previously, there is no consumer research in the company. Currently, I came up with the primary and secondary research for the company. In primary, they will look at the consumer market research, satisfaction survey, attitude survey, and opinion survey. I'm making these for the company, and they will then do this research, and they will get to know more about the needs of the customer. In secondary, market research reports, for example, companies like Mintel and other big consultancy companies, they can use their reports to actually know what are the consumer preferences. And last but not the least, they can use in-house data, for example, how much time a customer takes or how much time a manager takes to deal with the customer, and analyze that data and know the customer preferences. It will save the cost by around 3 to 5%. You can see in the notes. That is all from my side. I think it is really important for all the companies today to have an agile and at the same time sustainable supply chain strategy to make sure that they sustain in future. And I believe that my recommendation, even though I'm just at the implementation, start of the implementation phase, I will make sure that they work for the company. Thank you so much.